Morning, morning, everybody. Good morning. It's morning this side. Actually, it's not morning, it's afternoon. And I'm here with my princess. Say hi. Hi. How are you guys? How are you guys? I hope you all are doing good. And we thank God for this opportunity that He has given to us this day. It's another day, another video. And if you haven't subscribed, please consider subscribing. If you are our returning subscriber, thank you so much for always coming back to watch our video. And if you are watching this video and you haven't hit that subscribe button, please consider subscribing. Today is that day when you have to subscribe. So today is another day, and I'm so blessed to be here and to have this video with my baby girl over here, to do this video with my baby girl. Jazz, I'm about to fix or install gas cooker knob covers, the ones that I got from Jumia, and we're gonna do that. Sindo mama. So let's just do that, and then after that I'll be taking Jasmine to the market because I have to go to the gym. Have I shared with you the type of working style I'm having right now? When you meet up with me, I bet you're gonna laugh at me. I just kept the knobs here. I want to share with you a story as we get to fix the gas cooker knob covers. So these are the covers basically. You want this one? Okay. And then it comes with this sticker, these ones over here. So they are like this. Let's just open the other one I've given to Jasmine. Ta-da! I fixed one. And when you want to open it, you just do like that. Just open it like that. And then when you want to return it, you return it like that. So let me do the rest. So this is the progress, and I can see they're sticking so well. When you just want to use, you just open like that. When you want to use again, it's not easy to open now that a baby can open it. No, you have to like press it in. Yeah, so it's just good. And I'm on the last one. I'm here trying to fix this other one. Let's fix this one with you. I'm trying to look for a position where I can put this one with you, install this one with you. So it comes in a pack like this. And then it's inside, it has like a sticker. This one, it's a two-sided sticker. So we're just gonna remove this. Let me just finish this and then I tell you the story which I was supposed to tell you. Yeah, you just fix it up like that. And then the other sticker. Take the other sticker. You put it like this. I told you it's a two-sided sticker. Like it has gum on two sides. So let's fix this. So I'm just gonna stick it like that. Yeah. And I think let me just leave it for some time so that the glue can stick. The glue can stick. Yeah, just like that. It's looking cute. So I'm glad now that I got the covers. I feel now safe. I feel my baby is now safe. You know, at this stage, they're so curious. They want to touch this. They want to touch that. Touch. Okay, sorry. So I just took something from her. That's why she's crying. Anyway, I'm so happy now that I got the gas cooker knobs. And now I'm sure that she won't be able to play with the knobs again. And I just want to encourage I just want to encourage people who have kids this age and they have been experiencing the same thing as I. Maybe you can just find the gas cooker knobs. Yeah, and you'll feel secured. That's no talking. That's no shouting. No, that's no talking. Are you shouting? Hmm? Are you shouting? What's that? Are you shouting? What's that? It's a yes or a no. Are you shouting? You're going to fall. Jasmine is enjoying looking at herself and doing her things. Who is that? Who is that? Thank you. Thank you, mommy. Come and hug mama. Hug mommy. I'm crying. She doesn't like seeing people crying. Anyway, Jasmine, I just wanna tell my people's story. Don't cry. You're also crying. Don't cry, mama.
A few moments later.
What's up, guys? So I'm just from the gym,
though I have here my gym wear inside here. I had worn the trouser when I was going to town to take baby Jasmine to my mom's workplace, but then I decided to wear it coming home, because sometimes, you know, when you wear the gym wear coming back home, people will be like, you know. So just to avoid the attention, I had to wear my trouser back home. So I'm just from the gym and I'm coming back to my house, and I've been there for almost 2 hours. I took Jasmine to my mom's workplace at around 4. Right now it's 6 p.m. I'm coming back. And I wanted to share with you a story. Yeah, I've not forgotten about that. So can you imagine? I got conned. And I can't imagine that guy conned me. Is it a man? Is it a lady? I don't know. So it was end month. I decided to get myself shoes. Sneakers, you know, sometimes you feel like this is the time when I should get myself shoes. So I decided to get myself shoes, and it's a page called Sneaker Supermarket. I'll be posting the page right there. It's on Instagram. You know, for me, before I order something from Instagram, I usually look at the followers. So they had so many followers, and I knew this thing is legit because they had so many followers. So what I did is I ordered one sneaker. This guy asked me that I give him my information, where I come from, where the shoes are supposed to be sent to, and he also gave me a number where I was supposed to send the money. So I took my phone, made the payment, sent him my location, gave him my number. And when you do that, because I've been like ordering some things from Instagram page, but they were legit. But unfortunately, this time around, I met a con man. So after I've made my payment, I tell this person, I've already made payments. The shoes were costing, how should I say, it's like $21. Yeah, $21. Yeah, if I'm not wrong, $21. It was some nice sneakers. I'll be putting them there. You guys tell me if those sneakers were not good. So I buy those sneakers. I sent the guy the money. He goes silent. So I'm like, what's up? I text him on Instagram. I even call him, but he's not picking up. I text him, hello, when are you going to put the shoes so that they can be delivered to Kisumu? The guy goes silent on me. And I'm like, okay. I try calling. He blocks me. I tell my friend, go and check this particular Instagram page and also order a shoe from there.
My friend goes, makes an order. That guy replies. But for me, I've been texting him and texting him, but he doesn't reply me now. He goes silent on me. So I wonder, like, where did I go wrong? Is this girl legit? So my friend texts him, and the guy gives him the same information that he was giving me. It's when I came to realize that this guy was a con man, when my friend tells him to return my money back. Then the guy blocks my friend. Then I said, it's okay, I've been conned. It's okay, I accepted the situation, and I accepted that I've been conned. And you guy, wherever you are, the days of a thief are numbered. And I know if you're used to doing that, one day you'll do that thing, the same thing that you do to other people out there, you'll do to this particular person who'll teach you a lesson. You will be caught. Guys, I got conned. Like, I got conned. This is mostly happening, mostly in Nairobi and also everywhere. Generally, people are conning people. Life has become very difficult in Kenya. Very difficult. Again, I remember this incident. So I'm just standing somewhere and people are passing, looking at me, wondering, what is this lady doing? So I'm just here. Let me see if someone is coming. So I remember this day. Okay, this side looks clear. It's getting late. That's why it's becoming dark. So I remember this time when my mom had gotten an accident. She was involved in a picky accident. She boarded a picky and then they fell down and she had a problem on her knee. So this time I was helping my mom. After the accident, I was helping my mom go to the market for almost 1 month. So there was this day my mom wanted to buy rice from a broker, the people who sell them, actually, these things. So my mom wanted to buy rice from that person. Then she confused one number like this. It went to a different number. And can you imagine, this guy was from our tribe. You know, in Kenya we have tribes like Luo, Kisi, Luya. So like, for me, I'm a Kisi. So this guy that the money had gone to was a Kisi. So my mom called this guy and told him that he should return the money. But can you imagine, the guy told my mom, you know, I also have problems and I've used that money to sort out my problems. You're sorting out your problems with someone's money. Like, really, even my mom was telling him, no, that money is very urgent. Just return. Even it was $130. Let's say with the rates, actually in Kenyan shilling, it was 13,000. And I don't know how I can put it in dollars, but I think maybe $110 there, or $100. So my mom tells the guy, take $30 and then send the rest of the money. The guy tells my mom, no, that's not possible, I've already used the money to do something else. $30 free money, you've been given $30 free money. Can you refuse such an offer? No, you can't. But then the guy decided to be selfish. He decided to be selfish and he took that money, the whole of the money. He never bothered returning any shilling to my mom. That money my mom had just collected from her business to send for rice. And then this guy just takes it away. This guy never bothered returning any shilling to my mom. And at that time, remember, she was sick in the house. She was depressed. She was like, hey. That was the toughest time my mom went through. It was so tough for her. Her money had gone. She was in pain. And it wasn't long time ago. And I wonder where such people get the courage to just take people's money like that. It's not good. But what I know is, the days of a thief are numbered. The days of a thief are numbered. Anyway, that was just my story. And for me, I was just conned just recently. And I haven't believed that I have become a victim, but it's okay. So I'm back home. I just wanted to tell those people who are living in Kenya, just tell a friend to tell a friend about this Instagram page.
if it was possible, I could have reported the page, because you never know how many people this guy has conned. So, sad news is my grandpa has to go through surgery, and for him not to stay with the catheter, and it's also leaking that place where they cut. So just to avoid the infection and so many things, at his age, I just feel like he's going through a lot, and I feel so bad for him. So I think my mom is organizing on how the surgery is going to be done, and you know, please, all of you out there, please put my grandpa in prayers. Yeah, and I will really, really appreciate it so much. Also, I have a friend. She has a YouTube channel. She's from Italy. She's called Simona. I'm gonna leave her link there, her YouTube link. You can please also go and support her. She's going through a lot, and by you watching her videos, it will really, really boost her so much. Please, let's go support her, even if it means just subscribing to her channel. It will mean a lot to her. So please, let's go support her. Thank you so much in advance. Let this account be known by everybody so that they cannot be conned, they cannot be victims like I was. And right now, I just want to start cooking for my baby, because I know when she comes back, she'll just be all over me. I just want her to come back when I've already prepared. So let me just go take shower, and then this is how I get to end my video. I know it wasn't a long video, but I wanted to share with you guys how my day has been. And thank you so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed, please consider subscribing, and always know that we love you so much. And please, you can leave a comment there telling me what you guys want me to do for you, which content you want me to do. And if it's possible, I'll always do it for you guys. Thank you so much. Let me take a shower, cook. I have so many things to do. Catch you later in my next video.